knows what evil lurks in the heart of games. The Shadow Knows.
Hi, I'm The Shadow Knows, and I'm back with another Let's Play the Atari 2600 video. Tonight I play the game Sea Monster. Yeah, and it already looks really, really bad. I'm not sure if you can see the instability of the screen. It changes size during the becomes bigger, smaller, and that's not my TV dying. Ah, okay, I'm that almost invisible thing on top of the screen. Yeah, this is not a great game. But is there a time limit, or do I just have to die often enough? It could be made by the same company that made Condor Attack, which had also screen stability issues. Holy shit. This really isn't a good game. I mean, again, probably if I had this as a kid, I would still have played it, because I didn't have that many cartridges, I think 15 or 20. And yeah, every game, no matter how good it is, gets boring sooner or later, so... So I definitely would have played this, but not very much. And the almost invisible player sprite is the most fluent in the entire game. Everything else looks... It feels jerky. It's hard to describe. It's probably not that jerky. But compared to a random Activision game, it's really jerky. It's really hard to describe. This is not a good game. But on the other hand, it's really hard to get anything out of the 2600. So, even though this is not a great game, it's still an achievement to produce a game at all on the 2600. And it is sort of playable, so... Yeah, but... Imagine paying... I don't know how expensive video games were in the United States or in England, but... the top games were more than 100 German marks. So basically 10 times... or more the price of a Mastertronic game. They were cheaper games. So I think the average price for an Atari game in its heydays, in 81, 82, maybe 83, were around 60 to 80 German marks. And then there were those Quelle soft games, which were significantly cheaper. I know that the later ones sold for 20 or 30 marks. They may have been a little bit more expensive in the early 80s. And this would have been a candidate for a Quelle soft game. I'm not sure if it was actually released by them. Yeah, you got some really weird and some really crappy games when you bought a Quelle soft game. And you could also be lucky and just get a hacked version of an Activision or a Magic game, or of a real good game, for the same price. Yeah, and I'm not going to play this again. It's really not a great game, and an unstable picture always grants a crappy game. So that's a good indication. If you can see a game and you can see that the picture is unstable, and I don't mean any instabilities caused by PAL NTSC issues. That's a PAL cartridge running on a PAL system. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, and thanks for watching.